Video, I'm going to show you how to remove the background from this photo. So once you've got the photo chosen that you want to use, go up to Layers. And the first thing I do is duplicate the background because this one's locked and we won't be able to move it around later. So right click, then duplicate it, and then turn the background layer off and rename the background copy. So right click on the copy and click Rename, and I'm just going to call it Current Layer. And then we need to make our selection, so come up here to the Select Area tool, and this icon will be different depending on what the last tool that you used was. It just defaults to the last one, so click on that, and we want to choose the Lasso selection, so click on Lasso. And we're just going to make a rough selection, so just start clicking and dragging. And then we're going to fine-tune it after. I'm using a mouse for this, but I typically use a Wacom tablet. Just find it a lot more precise. Okay, and then we need to invert the selection because we need to choose the background. Right now it has the people chosen. So if we hit delete it, we'll remove them. So invert the selection. And now the background is completely chosen. So click delete selection. And then choose clear selection. And now we're going to go in and fine tune it. So choose the magic wand, and I have the tolerance at 29. I'm just going to leave it at that, and click on contiguous, and this is going to look for pixels that are of similar color that we want to delete. So we did a pretty good job there, it looks like it. So let's choose delete selection and clear selection. That looks good. So let's just keep going around the image and delete. And you can clear it each time between selections if it's easier for you to see. Or you can just keep making your selection. It's up to you. Clear that. Whoops, it chose her leg. Don't want that. So just choose clear selection and start over. Just do it in increments if that's easier. Probably safer. Clear that. Let's zoom in a bit. Hit your space bar. And you'll notice your cursor turns to a hand, and then you can just click and drag your canvas. Whoops. So maybe if we put our tolerance down a little bit, won't choose her leg. Yeah, that's better. It's not choosing her leg now. So just play around with the tolerance. Every image is going to be different. Clear that. So to clean up these little bits here, it's going to take forever if we just keep using this magic wand tool. So I think it's easier if we go up here to the eraser tool. So click on that. And then just come down here and erase these bits. I'm going to zoom back out. Let me go back to the magic wand tool. The select area tool and the magic wand, and let's choose that. Whoops, clear selection. Let's zoom in a bit. Hit the space bar, get your hand. Let's try that, and then let's increase our tolerance here. By that clear selection. Let's go back up to the eraser tool. And we want this area in here between his arms and the area behind the lady's hair. So let's go back to the select area tool. I normally would do this much quicker and I'd be a lot more efficient, but I wanted to give you an idea how you can flip from back and forth from these different screens to utilize the different tools. So we also want to uncheck contiguous. So uncheck that so that it chooses the pixels behind her hair and also behind this lady's hair. And also his arm. Because if we have, I'll just show you, if we have contiguous checked when we do that, it's only going to pick these pixels and not the pixels in his arm or her hair. So let me just show you that. So let me unselect that. And I'll check contiguous. And I'll check here. And see, you'll notice that it's only choosing those pixels that are close to each other, which are contiguous. So let me unselect that and unselect contiguous and do that over. So click that and see it chose his arm and behind her hair. So choose delete selection. And clear. And let's zoom in a bit to 200. See if we can get some more of those pixels removed. Zoom back out. That looks pretty good. I mean, I could be more precise, but for the sake of this video, I'm just going to leave it like this. And I'm going to go ahead and just add a solid colored background. So come up here and add new layer and add empty layer. And then we want to put this layer underneath the current layer. And then come up here to the fill tool. And we can change our colors over here. So if you want to have a black background, click OK, and then just click on the canvas. And you can change that to whatever you want. So click on there. I'm going to change it back to yellow. Click OK. And then what I'm going to do is add an express template. So go click onto the current layer and come up here to add express template. Click on that. And I'm going to add this ocean dreaming template, but I'm going to remove some of the elements from it. So double click. And I don't want the text, so I'm going to uncheck those. And those little boxes on the side and those dots on the bottom. Oops. So I'm going to keep everything else. So I'm going to go ahead and just delete those. So just click to select more than one. Hold down the Command key on a Mac. And then just click on those layers that you want to delete. And then right click and choose Delete Layer. And say yes. And then I want to move the current layer of the people. I want to move them so that they're in front of the white box. They're behind it right now. So I want them to be in front. So click on that layer and just drag it to the top. And you'll just have to drop it and drag it. It's not scrolling to the top. So just keep dropping and dragging until you get it to the top. There we go. So now they're on top of the box. And the only other thing I want to add here is some text. So choose the text tool. And then just click where you want to add the text. And just start typing. So I'm going to call this Celebrate. And to change the size, just go ahead and highlight it. I'm going to change it to 500. And I have to change the size of my text box here. So just click and drag. And then choose this little check mark. And then if you want to move it, if it's a little too low, choose the move, pick and move tool. And then just click and drag and put it where you want it to be. And if you want to change the color of the text or add a shadow box, a drop box, make sure that you click on the text tool and then highlight. And then you can change the text color here, or you can change the border color, or remove it altogether. Or you can have a shadow. I'm not going to put a shadow on it. I'm just going to leave it like that, leave it the way it was. So just click out of there, hit the escape. Whoops, I didn't mean to do that. There we go. So if you're happy with that, just choose your export or your save selected photo as. Or if you want to keep working on the layers at a future date, just click the library and it prompts you if you want to save your changes in a temporary file for further editing, and then just say yes. I'm just going to export the photo. It's going to keep it and just name it whatever you want to name it. Cyberlink Photo Director Tutorials Triptych. I don't know. It just automatically named it that. I'm just going to call it Celebrate. And then just choose export. I'm not going to do it because I've already saved it. So hit cancel. So that's it. And if you want to go ahead and add another template, you can do that too. So we could add this one. So double click. And I like this, except I don't like the black lines in it. So I'm going to uncheck the black lines. And then I'm going to delete them. So right click and delete layer. Say yes. And you can change the opacity if you want. Or you can change the blending mode. I'm just going to keep it on normal. So, yeah, that's it. You can just keep adding Express templates if you want to. It's up to you. But I'm just going to keep it like that. So, I hope you found this tutorial helpful.